Koikova occasionally plays the offlane, sometimes plays middle, but I think Ember is more of a sinking hero.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure Koikova is extremely competent at Ember Spirit, but you know, I think is one of Sing Sing's best heroes for sure.
We actually have one of the best Ember Spirits in the world in our slot with us. You know, going back to Star Lab, we have to ask our tour. We're gonna ask him to play this hero.
That was one of the funniest games I think I've seen in a really long time.
He was talking to us at
the game when he just bought four random items, no progression at all. He kept just beating diebacks, just hilarious.
I like how he's in the slot.
Oh god, we're just flaming the living hell out of him, and I'm okay with that. I'm kind of interested to see if this mid lane Lone Druid. I mean, I think it matches up very well against Ember. Because your main hero, you can stay for the most part away from Slight, but the bear is actually really good against Ember because he does not have a lot of HP. He'll take a lot of damage from the bear, especially if you get an Orb of Venom or something.
Yeah, you get an Orb of Venom plus an Entangling Claws proc and all the things, you're just going to kill that Ember
dead.
Spirit. Yeah, so that's something to keep in mind. And maybe they think this is a safe lane Lone Druid or something. I'm not sure, but... this is, I think, a really solid draft for Power Rangers thus far. Batrider getting stacks and then Jomo getting towards his Blink Dagger is going to be very important. Blinking and last wing Legion Commander before she can get her duel off is going to be very important in this game. And I think there are ways to shut down this Team Tinker lineup. And especially with Lasso and Root against Ember Spirit, it's very important that you lock him down, and Ancient Seal as well. So this is not the best Ember Spirit game for me, at least, in a nutshell. I think that this could be really, really bad for Team Tinker. We'll have to see what they pick with their fifth pick here. It's going to have to be a core. They already have their Ogre. They already have their Rubick. Power Rangers will pick up their last hero here, which will also be a core, more than likely. And probably their safe lane hero, assuming they send Lone Druid mid, which is not 100% guaranteed yet.
Yeah, just because they've done it recently,
5 seconds.
And obviously this doesn't guarantee it, but it seems like it's definitely possible for them to just shove that in the lane again, especially with the matchup.
This is Nexus's Wraith King. He played this very well in that second game, and this is pretty much the exact lineup they ran yesterday in the last game between Complexity. But it worked very well for them. They just need to play smart. And they were on the dark side as well, so they know what to do. They know when to take Roshan. They know how to be aggressive. Split pushing was, I think, the most important thing for them. Lone Druid, and they did that very well up until the last couple of minutes of the game where they got caught out in Complexity. They were 2 racks down, and they almost came back into it with a very farmed offlane Alchemist, by the way. Almost came back and took the game from Power Rangers. But... with that being said, Power Rangers did take the victory. They're 1-1. Team Tinker, their first series here for the Dune Pit. Season 2, group stages. We are going to be underway in just a minute with the last pick coming out for Team Tinker here.
Luna banned out in the last round of the draft, and Luna is sort of up there. Terrorblade has not been touched. Are these teams insane?
They just don't have the same ideas, maybe, as some of the other Western teams.
That hero just seems beyond good.
Well, we've also seen it get crushed, though.
Get crushed, but I guess it depends on the style of play. I mean, if you like to play aggressive at all, he's pretty terrible. He needs a long time. He needs, a mana style, and then he can sort of split push. I guess maybe it's sort of just qualifies as, one of those Envy-type heroes or, any of those other hard farmers.
Yeah.
I guess Tinker don't really... I mean, I feel like Terrorblade could be a really good Koikova hero.
I mean, I feel like any hero could be a really good Koikova hero.
That's true, yeah.
It's just like... Well, he's a Vengeful Spirit. You know, that's a really good Koikova hero right there. It's just like, well, yeah.
Every hero is a good Koikova hero.
No, but I see what you're saying, though. I agree with you 100%. That's something that he even mentioned beforehand in the live creeps. He's like, I want to hit creeps, guys. Like, well, you might be able to do that. And it is going to be Sing Sing and the Ember Spirit, Pycat, and the out for Team Tinker. This was on a Reddit post before. Somebody's like, yeah, go mid Ogre Mega. It's fine.
Yeah, I think this will probably be offlane because of... although, he's going to run into quite a few issues here if it is.
I mean,
there's a Wraith King, there's a Vengeful Spirit, there's Skywrath Mage, doesn't matter too much, but 2 stuns seems like it might be a bit difficult. I mean, part of the reason that people are thinking it's viable now is just because his HP regen is much higher now. It's it's 2.5. So Nyx Assassin is the highest, I think, around 3. So that's quite high for a hero. He went from 0.25 to 2.5. And it's possible that sort of brings him into you know, maybe a chance for him being in that offlane.
I mean, this is just a crazy draft from both sides. You don't usually see a mid-lone druid, and the only reason that I know that it is a mid-lone druid is because of yesterday's game. So if there is one thing that's constant on Team Tinker, though, it's that the supports are going to be EGM and Bulba 99% of the time. And you see that here clearly. So for Team Tinker, your rating team, first game for the league season number two, a team that's seen a lot of play recently, a lot of good results as well. Looking forward to seeing what they can bring in the next couple of months. We'll have Vinxing. He'll be playing your Ember Spirit, EGM on the Earthshaker. Bulba, he's going to be playing your Rurik. We'll have Pycat. He's going to be playing your Legion Commander. And Koikva is going to be on your Ogre Magi, rounding out the lineup of Team Tinker. But
yeah, it looks like they're getting a bit close to each other. But J4, he's going to be on the Wraith King. Skywrath Mage, it's going to be Weejus Zik. It's going to be Nexus on the Vengeful Spirit. We've got Cheshire Cat, the Bat Rider, and I think J4. Nope. All up top, Shocklo. He's going to be on
the lone druid. I was clearly wrong. It's not going to be a mid lane.
I mean, it seems like it could have been completely fine, honestly.
Yeah. But they also have Nexus playing the Vengeful Spirit, which is he's the core player for Power Rangers, and this might be a core event, but I'm not so sure. J4 does have the Sanctuary Ward on him. We just like has the Observer, so it looks like it's going to be your support duo, and a good support duo that is. J4, he won't have that much mana to work with in terms of Wraith Fire Blast, but he has one clarity to work with as well, so that can be fine. Double damage rune picked up for the Lone Druid Bear. I don't think that actually
just denies
works.
It, yeah.
It doesn't even work, so. And Aggro Tri coming out now from Team Tinker with Sing up at the top lane, mid lane, Pycat, Legion, solo safe Ogre Magi.
Well, I'm interested to see what kind of items he builds to keep himself relevant past BKBs. Because, I mean, Batrider's going to get a BKB, Wraith King's going to get a BKB. Like, those are just default BKB carriers. Obviously, the other heroes might stop for it as well, but they've got a couple just normal BKB heroes on their team anyway, so.
Koikva just pieced out of that lane. He's like, I don't think so, guys. Nope, I'm gonna get Arcane Bolted anyways. He's gonna pop his Fire Blast real quick. He's gonna try to man up on Weejisek, and he actually has boots. Weejisek, I don't know if he can really fight this. Another Fire Blast in 6 seconds. Koikva can get a solo kill, but I don't think they're gonna keep going for this. Ooh. He wants it, he can't get it. Against his better judgment, he will back away. And Koikva plumped very aggressively, which I like a lot. I mean, he's regening up like crazy. He hits a tree. He just regens casually back up to about full health. Pretty nice.
Look at that regen. 3.2 with nothing. That's pretty impressive stuff.
That's really nice.
We'll find out if this is enough. I mean, it seems like he will sort of be not farming that much just because of the way that things have worked out here. There's still actually going to be that Ember Spirit versus the Lone Druid matchup as put Pycat middle on the Legion Commander. So during the draft, I was talking about Legion just has not had a lot of success recently, honestly. Like, since being out of the patch, I think every single time I've seen her play, she just loses. So maybe mid is a little bit hero for a little bit faster levels.
Yeah, the thing is she's going against a Batrider. Pycat's going against a Batrider, and he's already taking a hell of a lot of damage. Yes, he has a magic stick, but he's got to get this early bottle. However, he's not even in terms of CS at the very least, so that's nice. Cheshire Cat's coming in. He's like, I can throw my overwhelming odds down. In fact, he just did. He has his press the attack as well, so
he should be fine because he can purge off the stacks.
That's
actually
true.
Pretty smart.
Yeah, that's something that I completely just forgot about. But
yeah, that ability is pretty insane.
Yeah, that's actually. I mean, he's got a good kit. You have a lot of good abilities on Legion Commander. It's just like you talked about, not the success that you're looking for. Top lane, this Lone Druid at 3 last hits. They're shutting him down pretty effectively. Sing Sing at 7, and they have a nice big creep coming here for Sing to take all this farm. And Koikva is getting zoned out. He's level 2. So they are doing a nice job getting Nexus farm in the bottom lane. In fact, he is the top CSer in the game at 15. And the Core Venge is something I haven't seen in a while. Meanwhile, they're going to use the Custom Shot, Wraith, Fire, Blast, Quill, and Trouble, but very tanky. He does have boots of speed. He is slow, but he should be fine. Yeah, he's just, they can't kill him.
He's got a lot of HP. He's got no HP items and over 600, so it's pretty nice for him. And I think until the Venge commits, they just won't be able to kill him, to be honest.
So. The benefit of having two heads. You're just double the tank coming after Ogre Magi.
Bulba and EGM are rotating a bit in the jungle here. It looks like maybe they were seen up by this ward up in the jungle, so no surprises there, but I think
they have the same idea.
Yeah. So they're just going to be roaming through here, but a very nice play by Pycat there.
Really smart, just sent the illusion out. Now he'll just back away and. A lot of time wasted coming quick.
They
want to get
killed
here. They might find J4. And Fire Blast is going to go from the high ground. There's the Ignite as well. Pycat Gonna use press the attack coming through. J4 getting caught out. Body blocked by Quirk. The beauty.
Yeah, overwhelming odds.
They have overwhelming odds, but they're not gonna get the kill with it. Just one right click. Quirk should grab this. And no, that's first blood going to your solo safe lane, Ogre Magi.
Top lane going on Shotlow, though. Two TPs coming in. Are they gonna try to go for this kill? No levels in Slight. I don't think so.
Very close.
Yeah, Sing, with one level and Slight, that's probably a kill, but Sing Sing is going for a bit of a different build here, just trying to stand up to any grass that comes in the lane. Kind of an interesting choice here. I mean, the chains is pretty good against the bear, so you can just make sure you don't get run down.
Cheshire Cat will pick up an Invis rune, and those rotations were actually fantastic coming out from Power Rangers, but this leaves Quickfoot getting at least some room in the bot lane, and you've got to be careful. Vengeful Spirit could take a lot of damage from like a level 2 Fire Blast, Quickfoot manning up, but at the same time, Magic Missile should be enough, and Wave of Terror to Armor Reduce should be pretty nice as well, so.
Yeah, and Pycat controlling the runes here fairly well. I mean, both these heroes have really good wave clear, so this is kind of an interesting little matchup we've got going on here. Obviously, overwhelming odds, you max that out. Very good wave clear, and Firefly, I don't think we're going to talk about the wave clear as well. So.
Top lane, top initiation. Lane,
oh boy.
J4 gets Selkie, he's back to Dead Fisher. There's no stun left. J4 will back away. The bear getting low. They want this kill. They want the 300 gold. It looks like they won't be able to get it. EGN gets Archer bolted. Sing Sing still with no point in Sleight of Fist. Top lane is just a brawl now. They've switched the lanes around, and this could be huge destruction coming out in just a couple of minutes.
Okay, well, bottom lane, Koikva versus Nexus. Koikva's at a pretty heavy level disadvantage here, because Ventral Spirit's just been, like, AFK farming in lane. Mm-hmm. Also has treads, so Koikva needs to be a bit careful here. I'm still not sure he can actually die to this hero as long as he's fairly careful and doesn't get, like, out of position and eat, like, two stuns or something like that.
Yeah.
He should be okay. I mean, this is just kind of weird now because you do have to be careful. Venge does put out a surprising amount of damage at these early levels.
Yeah, I mean, Wave of Terror. Wave is very real. They actually are just ridiculous. Then you get armor reduction. And as tanky as the Ogre Magi is.
Yeah, the hero's rotating down. I think they need to kill this Venge. Yeah, she's very fragile. She does have treads, bringing her actually to a pretty healthy HP of 910.
She'll still get bursted down, I mean, even with treads, but at the same time, they aren't going to go for the kill. Venge realizes that something's amiss. She rotates back towards her tower. They see that there are heroes missing top lane. EGM will get some room levels as well, which is very important. He's sitting currently at level 3. He is ahead of J4. Bulbo's only at level 2, so we've got to find ways to get levels as well. Maybe have a switch for Bulbo if they want to smoke behind mid. EGM room Pycat looks like he's going to grab that as well. He does have duel now, by the way. And they can try to go for a kill sometime in the near future, and they might do so.
Yeah, you want to make sure you get that first one, so I imagine we'll probably wait till the rotation comes through with Bulba. And Koikova are here in the mid lane, so maybe you want to make moves on Cheshire Cat. They have a good way to set this up with Lift and Fire Blast into the duel, so they have to be a bit careful as J4 is kind of standing in the back. He's also level 2. Now they're going to move forward.
Oh, it's coming out. Now they're not going to go for this anymore. Koikva gets stunned with the Wraith Fire Blast. Magic Missile, Koikva in some trouble. There's overwhelming odds coming through.
Oh,
Swap Duel coming out. Cheshire Cat not really taking any damage. He will survive the duel. Fable not doing much. Pycat, they've lost two heroes. Concussive Shot. Beautiful rotations from Power Rangers to stop that gank. And Cheshire Cat lives with about 10 AP, so...
Yeah, they were beyond ready for that. I mean, J4 was standing there, immediate TP reaction by Vengeful Spirit, good Firefly as well to give them a little bit of extended vision there, and yeah, they were just completely ready for that gank, and as a result, Tinker loses two heroes. The duel did not go either way, though, so at least he didn't lose the duel.
Yeah, that's true. It could have been a lot worse, just giving up damage to the Batrider, so... They keep things about even, other than obviously the two kills going the way for Rangers. Nexus gets involved as well, so he gets up to a stick, Aquila. He's starting to do some damage now. The real question is, what do you actually build on the Quakefish?
There's a lot of options. What'd you say?
Maybe a Manta, that's the point.
Manta, I think Yasha's pretty good. SNY is surprisingly good on the Tiro because you get the HP from it. The movement is pretty relevant as well. Occasionally the main can get you kills just because of the right-click damage you can put out. So I think it's an item that is more common on this hero than many other carries. But Yasha, I think something with a Yasha will definitely mean his near future.
Well, they're going to go for a spear to see gank, so that's the item that he chooses to pick up now. And they're looking for a gank. Bulma way out of position. Wraith Fire Blast. Telekinesis nicely done. Magic Missile. Will they dive? This Fisher coming out as well. Bulma still alive. Great reaction time swap. Poikva trying to get this kill on Nexus up to the high ground. Fire Blast is going to be there. Ignite's going to fly out in just a second. Nexus looks like he will fall. TP coming through. No, sir, you aren't going to make it out. EGM with the Enchant Totem grabs the kill. And that's really great reaction time for Team Tinker to pick up that kill.
Yeah, well played there. This is also really important because meanwhile, Bulba is just getting levels, which is really important because Rubick needs to get level 6 as soon as possible. Like, that's, you can't overstate how important it is for that Rubick to get the level 6. Spellsteal obviously just opens up such a huge opportunity for you. Stealing Wraith Fire Blast is huge. Most of Skywrath's spells are very, very good. You can steal the Bear from Lone Druid. I mean, that's very unlikely, but the Wraith Fire Blast is insanely good on Rubick, just because his mana pool is way higher, obviously, than Wraith King's. So, Bulba just needs to find some room.
Yeah, that's they're not really giving him anything though. I mean, you have Sing Sing in the bottom lane taking the bottom from top lane. Koifa's been sitting there for some time. Mid lane EGM sitting here. I think actually maybe Sacred Farm is a bit more important than Bulba's, but I don't know if you can really.
Bulba just needs level. Earthshaker actually needs farm. He needs arcanes. He needs blink dagger, and he just doesn't really have much of anything, to be honest. So he is just soaking XP in the mid lane at the moment, and pretty much all Power Rangers are down bottom. It looks like they think there's gonna be pressure or movement on Nexus here. I'm not sure. I don't think Team Tinker are even close to interested in really committing on this. Bulba is just gonna pull and get levels. Sing Sing is just gonna keep farming.
Yeah, and until Sing Sing gets up towards like his first battle fury and drums, I don't think they're gonna put too much aggression. They'll probably try to gank here on Shocklow again in the near future, but can they get the kill is a question. He actually has enough money for Mask of Madness, so.
Yeah, this is a little bit scary. I mean, I have no idea how good Mask of Madness is on the bear. It seems fairly solid. Good, honestly.
I mean, built it yesterday. It was a solid choice. It
gives you very quickly, but gives you a good shot at Entangling Claws. But at the early levels, like, can they even burst down 2,700 HP? Even if you haven't, they're going to move on Shocklow. That's a huge amount of stacks there. He's dueled as well, and he is absolutely going to go down here, but not in the duel. Again, they miss out on that duel damage.
So close.
They need to get that. That's a pretty important part
of their lineup. They wanted to cast from Koifa, and had they got it, they could get that Pycat. Well, actually, 100% I'm sure they get the duel win. But yeah, this is just the first level duration's not long enough usually to get the duel win in all cases, whereas second and third level is really when you start, you know, stacking up the damage. So it's not the worst thing. They're stopping the Lone Druid from farming. Meanwhile, Bulba is just sitting in the trees here bottom lane. Stay in the trees, my friend, as Weejasick is looking for a bank. Mid lane, they are getting more farm for EGM. He's not level 6 yet. J4 throws a great fire blast. He's only level 4, by the way.
Pretty much fairly under level.
Cheshire Cap, Blink Lasso. Oh, he's got a DD as well. Cheshire Cap, meanwhile, EGM has a chance off. There's the Lasso going through. A lot of heroes coming in. They can't Fissure just yet. They will fight now. More TPs, they will grab the kill. Legion with the overwhelming odds on the Batrider. Now Shockwave, Searing Chant up. He is in trouble. There's the duel. This is going to be the first one coming out for Bulba. Well, excuse me, Pycat. Bulba gets the kill. Telekinesis. Nexus is falls. Well, what a disaster. Power Rangers give two kills away to Bulba. He's level 6 now and 800 gold in the bank. Beautifully done for Team Tinker. Nice.
Yeah, that is happy days for Team Tinker. They get the duel win. They get levels for Bulba. EGM even lives there. And that was a pretty incredible fight for them. EG now has arcanes, and he wasn't level 6. If he was level 6, that fight would have been even better for Tinker because he would have been able to echo while the Batrider was kind of wandering around. And I expect Tinker maybe going to press their advantage a little bit here. They want to get as many duels as possible, as quickly as possible. And you can also tell that Pycat's gone for the Blink Dagger first. So that's the item when you really just want to stack on the duel wins. Sometimes you see Armlet first. That's a bit more of just like a straight up fight item or a little bit of a farming item. So Blink Dagger, they won't play aggressive.
You could say they're trying to press the attack.
Oh my god. Dude, that was at least 8 out of 10. I'm not even going to lie.
This only happens with you is you just say something and I'll immediately think of a pun to follow up and I'll just say it in the most stupid, ridiculous way and everyone's just like failfish and I'm just like, sorry guys, listen, it's fine. Well,
Shocklow has no bear for like 20 seconds here. It's not that big of a deal, but I think he did finish the mask before he actually died. So.
Well, he purchased it, I think, after he died. I'm not sure.
Okay. Well, regardless, he doesn't have the mask is done, and Power Rangers are on the hunt through the Radiant Jungle here, but all they're going to find is EGM again, and when he has Echo, it's actually kind of hard to kill him because the animation is so fast.
Hit his R button and they can't lasso him. They also have the dude coming out. He will get lasted up immediately. Mystic Flare. There's the Echo Slam coming. Fisher not there. EGM does get it off. There's the dual Fire Blast. EGM falls. So Shock opening up quick for chasing after him. Here comes Sing Sing. Sharing Chains comes in. You got the Ember Spirit going to work. Oh, there's the Entangling Claws. Quick for Fire Blast is up and ready to go. No multicast. PyCat can't get the kill. He's pressing the attack, but he's getting Wraith Fire down. PyCat about to fall. Overwhelming odds. Ignite comes down as well. What a man fought. Sing Sing cannot get the kill on Shockwave. Fire Blast, multicast, Bulba zaps him. Fable comes in.
Ignite three gets for the kill.
Fade. Quick for. Look out, buddy.
Yeah, he has to run. TP coming in, he has to run. Another, I think that's another good, fairly good fight there for Team Tinker. They come out ahead a little bit on Golden XP. They also get a dual win. Every time you get a dual win, it's a pretty big deal. And now level 11 for Legion, and he's going to get even more damage. So PR need to figure out a way to sort of just CC down the Legion during those duels. Try to keep the people alive during the duels, and they'll be in a bit better shape. And again, the EGM just, he's not really interested in dying.
Well, that Mystic Flare missed on Koifa. They will do a lot of damage to him. Meanwhile, Sing Sing just grabs the kill on J4, the mid lane. So a bit of unfortunate gank coming out from Power Rangers. And now it looks like Team Tinker are just, they're pressing the advantage here. Again, they're just making sure Shaklo can't really find that farm for his lone druid. They don't want to get him involved in this game. Team Tinker want to shut him down as much as possible. Sing Sing now has his phase drum. He'll work towards his Battle Fury. Might be a bit late in comparison to what he usually gets, but still, this is a very solid game for Team Tinker now. They're not really making too many mistakes, and it feels like they're comfortable with what they've got going on. And on top of that, there's a chainmail coming out for Legion Commander, which might be the start of an Assault Kuras or
it's probably blade mail.
Yeah, blade mail makes the most sense.
Gets the tower.
And blade mail is fairly common on Legion. I think it's pretty good, especially because it basically makes it, you know, you try to kill me when I'm in duel, and that just does not work. So, I like that. And Shaco is just continuing to farm up here. It looks like he is probably going to be going for maybe Maelstrom. Yeah, probably.
The build yesterday. It was he bought like six different components yesterday, but it was Mom, Maelstrom, Mjolnir, I think, and then he picked up a Silk Kuras and then a Basher, I believe, was the straight decision, so.
Yeah. Sing Sing is super farmed. 76 CS, a kill, 5 assists, and he's got himself phase boots, drums, poor man's shield, and 1,400 gold. So we'll see if he still goes into the Battle Fury here in transitioning into the later parts of the game.
Duel,
I think he's incredibly good.
Dead as hell. Lasso coming in. Can they get the duel in? Yes, they do. The multicast coming out. PyCat now turning around. That slow turn radiate. They're going to jump in. It looked like Sing Sing gets bloodlusted. Fisher coming in. Boom. Look at the damage. Double kill from Koifa. J4, that's his ultimate coming down, and they'll probably kill him yet again. He gets caught out, Rage Fire Blast. Quickflow is probably not the target if you want to go for J4. Chance, no. Multicast, the triple kill coming out from the Ogre. Base Ice Frog gives him the RNG to get the kill.
Yeah, he can go stop at Vegas or something. He's gotten a lot of multicast, it feels like. Every fight, there's at least one, so. That's all you really need, and looks like it is going to be the Blade Mail for PyCat. No surprises there. He's going to harass Shocklo a little bit. No duel. Can't really kill Shocklo alone. The bear will actually tear him to pieces in the duel, so.
This has been quite the aggressive game, and you talked about the CS. I think it's more in terms. I mean, you talked about like 75 CS, and it's like 80 CS now at 16 minutes. It's not the most, but
when that's a lot considering how much they've been fighting.
Exactly. Yeah. Fighting has just been ridiculous, and I'm totally down for that. I mean, this is just a lot of early aggression, which is fantastic. This thing actually picks up a point booster. Might be going for an early Scotty rather than anything else here, which is very interesting. Usually you'd see that Battle Fury, but it is going to be that point booster coming out from him, and I like it, I think.
Yeah, I mean, I guess there's an off chance that it's like a Bloodstone or something, but it seems pretty bad.
Yeah, it doesn't seem the best.
It seems pretty mediocre, to be honest. But that's kind of an interesting choice. I mean, it does give him a ton of HP, and that's pretty important in this game with the bear going to be doing lots of damage and the Skywrath as well. So it's kind of an interesting build choice here, and Koifa's got an Aghanim.
Right. Yeah, he's ready to fight. He's been building that since day one. Meanwhile, there's going to be Sing Sing Chains coming out, but Sing actually gets pressed the attack off the Ancient Seal. Duel on Cheshire Cat. Out of position. He falls. PyCat getting yet another kill. And another duel win. He's up to 48 now. PyCat, he might be bringing this Legion around, showing everybody what it's good for here. So.
Yeah, I mean, this seems to be working a lot better. I think the quick levels are pretty important, and he's a decent solo laner, especially if they knew this bat was going middle. That was some... that was an impressive landing choice because Press the Attack is just so good against Napalm. I really like the way that Team Tinker have drafted this game. And, you know, we've seen Bulba drafting on and off for like the last couple of months since CI. And I think he's really coming into his own on this team. They seem to have a really, really good, you know, set strategy put together. They're executing extremely well. EGM has also been pretty standout this game, just not really dying and delivering some impressive fishers. Bulba's only died once as well.
That's the thing. But
everyone's only died once, except for six.
Oh boy. Rip, maybe? Thank you. There's the blade mail. Mystic Flare, Mag Missile. They take a lot of damage trying to get that kill just through blade mail alone, but they will get it nonetheless. Podcat finally goes down. And that gives them a decent amount of gold. Quickrist gonna run right into J4, who by the way has no reincarnation. Magic Missile. Quick the goddamn tanky. Here comes the bear. And Tangling Ball is going through. No, there's the Fisher connecting onto two. Where's the follow-up? EGM Ancient sealed up. He's looking to get this kill. J4 back up to pretty much half health. EGM about to hit that. Oh, he gets the ultimate off, but he cannot secure the kill. Three down, here comes Bulba. What are you doing, Sam? Wraithfire blast is exchanged. Four dead. What a disaster. Although Sing Sing did get the kill on Tishar Cat top, but 1500 gold, in fact, 2000 net worth change there. Power Rangers finally starting to get something going here. But that's actually pretty good. They were only leading by 5,000, and now it's about down to 2,500. That's a huge victory, and Power Rangers are going to take Roshan, or at least try to.
Yeah, that was a pretty unfortunate timing for that fight to occur. They lose a lot of heroes there. Sam dies at the end, probably a little bit unnecessarily, and that's just tough. I don't really know if there's too much they could have done about that fight at the end there. Bulba was just trying to get the kill on J4, so.
Pycat flinks in a bit too late to get the duel off. That would have been huge for Team Tinker, but no such luck. They give away Roshan, they give away the Aegis, and Shaco is feeling pretty comfortable now.
And that range is just too short to cancel either of those TPs. That's pretty frustrating.
I mean, it's pretty damn short.
It's basically melee, so.
It is melee. It's like right around your feet. It's just like, well, I guess I have to be on top of this person to duel him, so.
Yeah. You know, if you duel someone, you slap him in the face. You have to go next to him. That's how it works. Same thing, maybe gonna go on Cheshire Cat here. There's a lot of heroes behind him. They can definitely go on this. He's gonna go there. There's the chain. They latch, and Cheshire Cat is beyond dead here.
Oh, yeah. That's just Cheshire Cat getting caught out again. If there's one thing that's keeping Power Rangers out of this game, it might be some positioning errors, especially Cheshire Cat, who's died six times. This Batrider is not really doing well. I mean, this hero, we talk about it being so good, but Cheshire Cat is not having the best game.
This is rough. He also does not have a force yet, which is pretty unacceptable. It's 21 minutes.
They know Pycat's here, actually. They have a pretty good standing. They have their entire jungle warded, so.
EGM is working towards that Blink Dagger now. He needs to find himself some solo farm, I think. It'd be pretty nice. Maybe he gets level 11 and a Blink Dagger. But they're also would be happy with just a big team fight. Shocklo continuing forward, has 2,000 gold in that Maelstrom. We'll see. Upgrades it to the Mjolnir. Now with the bear having mana, Mjolnir seems insanely good on the bear.
It's pretty good.
Much easier to mana. You still get all the benefits from it, so.
He's split pushing pretty effectively as well. I mean, they're right at this tier 2 tower. They have the glyph over top lane. There might be a fight coming out. Searing Chain going Sleight of Fist as well. Magnusol, no. Swap coming through. Quickva gets a concussive shot and he'll have to back up. And that Aghanim still has it, but not quite getting anything done with it. Meanwhile, there's the glyph coming out in the bottom tier 2 tower. The split push is real coming out for Power Rangers, and this is to get them back into the game. Unless they lose a fight up in the top lane right now, which they might. Nexus. No swap out. He has used it already. He does have the Yasha, by the way. Multicast coming through. Deer Chain's gonna fly it as they have the remnant, but there's the last one. Cheshire Cat. Pycat already went to double for Pycat. There's 3-4 dead. Aegis and Reincarnation going. J4 throws up the Fire Blast. Get this kill. Big Echo coming in. Man, did they get some damage out there. Shocklo TP's up. This is an all idea, my friend. He's getting caught out. Sing low, but they will grab the kill with Mystic Flare. Pistol and Bulba getting the kill. Also for Pycat. Almost the rampage. Beautifully done. Team Tinker killing all five, and Cheshire Cat immediately calls GG.
That was one of the most one-sided fights I've seen in a really long time, and that's Pycat's damage out there. That was an incredible fight. They also, of course, steal the Mystic Flare for the Robins, and That was an insanely well-played game for Team Tinker. They did have a couple of moments where it looked a little sketchy. Their positioning was a little off, but for the most part, they played that game extremely well. Cheshire Cat just extremely behind that whole game. The four staff was just getting finished up there at the end, and rough game for Power Rangers. I think they weren't really ready for the lanes. I mean, they pretty much... Bottom, they didn't really lose, but they also never killed Koikawa. Middle, Batrider did not really do anything, and Toffland was a bit of a mess, so...
Yeah.
It just kind of snowballed. Power Rangers.
It snowballed out of control
for Koikawa, 8-2-7. Jesus, yeah. What a player.
Yeah, he did some work in that game. It just shows that Ogre Magi in any role can make work in this current patch. Some of the items are missing here, it looks like. I'm not 100% sure if that's the case, but it looks like they're missing anyway. Maybe I'm incorrect about that, but well, that is going to be a game one victory coming out from Team Tinker. Again, it's a two-game series, so they'll have a chance to even it up with Power Rangers here in game number two. We'll see if they can get it done. Guys, thanks so much for joining us. Check out DotaPit.com for more DotaPit information and action. Twitch.tv/DotaPit as well. Go ahead and follow there. We're Highground.tv. You can check us out at Highground.tv. And, of course, on Twitter, you can follow us. My name is Mont. You can follow me at Twitter.com/MontDota. With me is What Is Hip. You can follow him at Twitter.com/WhatTV. We'll be right back, guys. Stick around.